A new video about Anvil Carrack based on the information from CitizenCon 2949. Welcome back on my channel, I'm Ars Drake. Let's talk about the Anvil Carrack again. Anyone who knows my channel knows that I've already made a video on the subject, but based only on the information from Cloud Imperium from the concept phase. Here again, for the people who spoke to me that some information in the old videos was not up to date. This data was the official data of Cloud Imperium and not by a second provider. I know a lot, if not almost everything on the pages of the second provider are relatively correct, but it remains information from second hand and ships in the concept get changed some points, and I'm very carefully with my statements. But let us now come to the statements of John Crewe, Stephen Hausmer and Paul Jones on the Anvil Carrack, which will be published in February 2020. First, they gave us the known information, which section should include the Carrack. So, medical facility, repair room, garage and hangar, charting and sensor suites, reinforced and enlarged fuel tanks, modular storage system. The Carrack increased to the total length of 170 meter, so unfortunately a new problem arose. The Carrack became too big and could not land anywhere, so he had to get slimmer and smaller again. After a cure, the Carrack shrank down to 123 meters and that solved the problem. The concept of the bridge armor took some time because they had to try different concepts until they decided for this version. I like it personally. What was probably more demanding was the design, the ship as is typical for Anvil. It disappeared or changed some details of the concept to this design, as an example here the drives. The same applies to the interior. What is a pity is that the new concept of cartography has been changed back to the simple presentation of the star map, so that the new monitors for overview disappeared. I would rather have the option to have a detailed overview. The best way to see the changes is between the bridge from the concept and the bridge now, how it will come in the Carrack. What has definitely changed and is now confirmed is the cargo capacity. Originally rated as 1000 SEU, the capacity now stands at 456 SEU, which is actually the size of the vessel as well as other vessels of this size. The number of towers has not changed. There are still 4 towers, including 3 manned, the sides and the lower tower, and a remote tower on the top of the ship. But here too were some changes. The angle of the side towers had been unfavorably and had given relatively little protection, so they have adapted the function of the hammerhead towers for the Carrack, to have a better shooting angles. The Carrack launch and crew area were shown with the hint that the captain's cabin did not have a bigger bath, as did some rumors circulated about it. The drone hangar has 4 drones and 2 stations where each player can operate 2 drones simultaneously. The engine room consists of 2 decks with a separate space for the gravity generator. The biggest change in the design is probably the landing. Also, they did not want to use a tripod solution for the ship of this size or larger because of the stability, but this has offered the best resolution for the design of the Carrack. What I think looks better than the concept drawing. Otherwise, as I said in February 2020, the Carrack will be released if nothing changed. How do you like the design and the equipment of the Carrack? Has the designer team done its job well? Write me a comment on the subject. I'm interested in your opinion. If you like the video, support my channel by subscribing, otherwise I hope to see you again the next time. Your Ars Drake.